Hello! Hello, hello, hello. Today is Thursday, April 26th, and I wanted to just interrupt this regular schedule of vlogs that you guys are seeing or videos to let you know that next Friday, May 4th, I'm going to Europe, which is very exciting. So I'm actually gonna be gone for 4 weeks. So I have a lot of videos uploading while I'm gone, so you guys can, you might feel a little bit behind because some of the videos you'll see in May are from April and things like that, but it's gonna be exciting, and I just wanted to interject the schedule of vlogs to let you guys know that I will not be here, but as soon as I get back, I will be uploading. Like, I'm going to record while I'm in Europe. It might not be vlog style, but I will record a lot of the stuff that we do. I think it'll be fun and a nice way to kind of document the adventure. So, just wanted to let you guys know that you'll be seeing some older vlogs, but I will interject randomly with some stuff. Like sometimes it'll be twice a week, like for example, whichever week this vlog is in will be twice a week uploads, but usually it'll just be once a week. So while I was here, I figured I'd let you guys know some ways that I plan to travel healthily, because if you don't know me very well, I really enjoy international travel. I've been to a lot of different countries and cities. I'll have to actually sit down and figure it out and put that right here. I've been to a lot of countries and continents and cities. Very blessed, and that's how I choose to spend my money, and I like being able to travel and have those experiences. So the point is that every time I travel, I'm able to still, okay, sorry about that camera. Memory card ran out of life. Good thing I got one to replace it. But so I am always able to eat healthy and work out while I'm abroad, because I will either find a gym that I could join and pay for a day pass, which is kind of just like, you don't really want to pay for a day pass for a gym, but it's just when it's a priority for you, if you really are missing the gym and you want to go, it's worth it. And if I don't find a gym, I'll be able to do workouts like at home. Like as a personal trainer, I've developed a lot of knowledge and things I can do at home. But for example, there's on Pinterest, there's a ton of at-home workouts, no equipment, things like that. Or I will kind of just make up ones of my own, like doing like body weight things such as squats, jump squats, lunges, push-ups, planks, jumping jacks, a little bit more cardio based, but it's good to have that because, first of all, I already accept that I'm not probably gonna work out 5 days a week like I do at home, because I really wanna enjoy wherever I am and enjoy that country. So I know that I will want to have, maybe I always just like accept that I may only get like 3 days a week, which is fine, and I need to just understand that I'm soaking up the country that I'm in and it's exciting. So I accept that it's only gonna be a couple days a week, and then I make it quick, like 30 minutes or less, give or take, so that I can go and explore and do other things in the country besides working out. So first of all, that's number one, and then I also always make sure to stretch and kind of at least stretch every night to feel like I'm just keeping myself loose and comfortable and things. So then with eating healthy, if you're able to, if you have a kitchen in a lot of places, if I'm traveling by myself, you can get food at the market and like cook and just make it just like at home. But if you're not able to cook and things, you can still make healthy choices at restaurants. Like, you know, you need to try the food. I'm a huge foodie. You need to try the food that's famous. You need to try the food that's famous in that region. For example, like pasta in Italy and pizza and things like that that are not super healthy for you, but it's about the experience. So I know that I will be trying those things, and then maybe throughout the rest of the day, I will eat like a little bit lighter or things like that. But overall, I'm not going to miss out on an opportunity just because I'm trying to be very healthy. But in the end, I do know that I want to pick healthy foods that will make me feel good, and I don't want to eat something like too gross and greasy, because you're already kind of uncomfortable when you're abroad. You're out of your element almost like at all times. There's just a slight feeling of uncomfortableness and adventure and whatnot, which is nice, but you want to eat foods that are gonna make you feel good and energized and not even stress you out even more or cause more problems such as like indigestion or all of that fun stuff. So those are just some tips I've learned while being abroad. Hopefully I can show you guys that one there. Again, I'm gonna record the whole time I'm there, but I'm not gonna have my computer or anything. just for safety, so I'm going to upload when I come home. So hopefully those tips were helpful and hopefully something you guys can implement on your next vacation or travel or anything like that. Because though you are on vacation, if you still want to maintain your health status and still keep reaching towards your goals, it's important to remember your priorities even while you're abroad, especially because you want to feel good. And that's just something my mom always tells me, like before I get on my long flights, like don't eat anything too greasy or crazy, like just because you're on vacation, like you think that you may think like, oh, I can just eat this now, like I'm on vacation, whatever. But you do not want to feel like crap on long plane rides. I've been there. I had a 13-hour plane ride to Bangkok and we had a start in Chicago and I had pizza there, obviously. And I just woke up on the plane and felt like death, and it really hurt me for a while. Just all that sitting in my stomach, not digesting. So that's just a little side story, but hopefully these tips are helpful and just wanted to let you guys know that you won't be seeing me for a while, but I will be back and I'm so excited. And I'm also gonna record how I'm packing and things like that, so it should be helpful. Let me give you a little sneak peek of that now. I actually wrote down a list because I'm a huge list maker, things to do before Europe. And so the top is like stuff that I needed to do, like getting new, like birth control and bills and whatnot and budgeting. And then the side is what I need to bring. I just wrote it all out. And then clothes is a whole separate category. And then things I need to buy that I've either ordered on Amazon or I'm going to get at the store and things like that. And I bring, so I will show you guys this. When I do my video on packing, I actually bring just one big backpacking backpack. So I look like a hitchhiker and all that type of stuff, but it's so convenient, especially when you're switching between different cities every day. Like you do not want to be lugging around a suitcase. And ever since I've had the backpack, I take it everywhere, even if I'm only going somewhere for a week, because I get to take it on the plane. It's a carry-on. I don't have to worry about my luggage getting lost. But again, I'll get into all of that when I show you guys the actual packing video, which will be next week when I actually pack after I do laundry. That's on my list. So for now, hope you guys enjoyed this video and I'll see you in the next one.